Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I thought for my final design team project for Natasha Scrapbook Corner, I would do a tutorial. And again, please forgive my lighting is behind me and we're still having rain, so I want to make sure that the work that my husband did on the ceiling to patch up the leak in my ceiling fan is all dried up before I turn on the light above, you know, in the room. So I'm still using my light behind me, so there's going to be shadows casted. I thought I would use scraps again, and also this is items. Oops. These are items left over from my March design team package, so I will be using that to decorate her. And I thought I would, it's white, so maybe I can do a little bit of painting with my favorite paint. No, I think if I do that, if I do that, it's going to take some time to dry. So I'm just going to go ahead and decorate like this. So I have these little bits that are still I didn't finish. And, looks pretty cute right there. I need to try to figure out what I can do for the base here. Okay, let me see here. I have lots and lots and lots of scraps. Lots and lots and lots of bits I can use here. So, let me see. Do I still... This is old. This is an old piece that... Maybe I can use... Go all the way around. Oh, I think it will. Okay, so let's start with that. I just plugged in my glue gun, so hopefully, yep, it is hot enough for me to do this. Sorry again for the shadows, ladies. Don't forget, I'll have all the links below. And I love dress forms, so, and I do have quite a few that I have created and many videos on my channel if you're interested seeing all the different varieties of dress forms that I have made over the my years of being on YouTube. Let's take a look and see how that looks. I think I'm going to leave that. I could cut it, but I think I'm going to leave that. That looks kind of cute, right? Okay, and I did like the way this looked. And Well, maybe I could do that around the front. I don't know. We'll see. What else do I want to do here? I want to add what I think I'm going to do is I'm just going to add a bunch of bits. Just a bunch of scraps. Whatever I can find here. These are all past bits. And this will be a good way for you to use your scraps. You know me, I love using scraps. And let me see, this is a little bit here. And I always like the seam part, so I'm going to turn this backwards. Just like that. And I'm just bringing out whatever I can find here. No rhyme or reason. That's pretty. Let's take one of these. I hope everyone is staying safe. Let's see, how do I want to do this like this? And I hope everyone is staying positive. My husband's going a little stir crazy because he's so used to always doing things. But when he does things, it requires him, you know, going to Home Depot or whatever. And we are not going anywhere except to the store, so he can't really tinker around like he normally would. So, something white there. So he's getting a little bored. I'm just going around adding just little bits, different bits. Maybe something here. Yeah, maybe right there. Need something here. All of these laces I am using are all from Natasha Scrapbook Corner. Something like that. Hmm. Yep, maybe something like that. And I always try to, you know, leave edges, some edges open so that I can always tuck underneath. That's pretty. And let me use this one. Yeah, I think I want to do that. Again, be very careful for the newbies using the glue. I'm going to add a little bit of glue to the sides there. Glue is very hot, so I don't want you to, you see me touching it. My sure bonder is really, really hot. But I've done this so long that I kind of have a gauge for how much to push down so I don't burn my fingers. So please, please, for the new people, don't burn your fingers. Just wanna, that kind of got a little bubble there. There we go. And I glued on the shoulders there. Or on the arms, so that this doesn't move around. And I want to use that. Would be pretty, huh? Let's cut that. It doesn't go all the way to the back. But I really like the way it looks, so I'm going to do it anyway. Oops, I want it down a little bit more. There we go. Whenever you do layers, there's no point in layering if you're not going to see all the layers. So, I do try to make sure you can see the layers. Okay, that's like that. So, I think I just want to, I'm just going to leave that for now. I want to put something under that. Ow. I have so many little bits here. That might be good. Which side? These laces are so pretty. It's very, very difficult to figure out what lace is, what's the front and what's the back. And I'm going to add a little bit of glue here just to keep that from coming up. I hope I've been in screen. Okay, so, and then I'm going to add a little bit of glue along there. Pretty. Super pretty. That would be pretty back here. Here. That would be pretty to cover everything up, huh? I like that. Oh, I like that better. Okay, so there, and there. Pretty, pretty. I'm going to add a little bit of glue here because I want that to kind of stay down. Like that. So she's looking pretty so far, right? And I think I want this to poof out. So, what could I do? I could probably get some paper and add down there because I want it to poof out. If I had some cardboard close at hand, I could also do that. Let me see what I have near me here. Oh, I have this. This was given to me by Gail. Thank you, Gail. I'm going to use the cardboard. Love the little birdies. Those are paper clips. How stinking cute are those? Oh, goodness gracious. Okay, let's see. Are they glued down or? Okay, well, I think all I need is this part anyway, so I'm just gonna cut. Yeah. There we go. Sorry, guys, for the sidetrack here. Okay. All right. So, I think what I'm gonna do is, yep, cut that in half. Cut that in half again. I never measure anything. And then I'm just gonna round the corners. And how's my time? Might have to come back for part two, guys. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, and then what I want to do is I want to add that to this guy. And I think, yep, I think that'll do. I'm just going to pop a hole where I think is the center. And I'm going to do actually two holes because I don't know exactly where the center, but that's going to give me a little play area in the center. So if I do one here, one here, one here, one here, it gives me a bigger hole and then I'll be able to add this right where I want it. And then I'm just going to cut a slit. So that I can add, and first of all, I want to reinforce this like so. And I probably want to cover it. Want to cover it also, and I'm going to use this, I think. Or should I use bits? What can I use? All my other little tiny bits. Oh, I could use some of this. Yep, I could use this. Okay, so I'm going to add that there. I just want to cover. I hope I'm not getting in the way of everybody's view. Okay, and then I'm just gonna fit that in place there. Let me see, how did I have it? Okay, so like that. I just want to be able, like I said, to generally just okay. Now I can cut that again. Okay. And it doesn't matter which is, you know, this way or that way. It doesn't matter. Okay, so like so. Yep, that's going to be good. Trying to hold it up here. Okay, and before it dries, there, that's good. Pretty. And I'm just going to trim so it looks neat all the way around the edges. And let's use some of this stuff. Some of these little scraps. I think I want to use one of those for the back. There's some leaves that's already cut. So actually I'm gonna take that off distracting from your view. Okay, and make sure I have this. That's the right side. Oof, be careful, don't burn yourself. These little trims. Pretty. Very nice. I couldn't decide what I wanted to do there. And like so. I hope you guys can see. That's where I slid it down the center there. Okay, and then, do I have some more leaves? I do. Let me cut some more leaves. Okay. Yep, ow. Just a little bit. Just a little owie. I'm gonna cut that right there. Okay, so now we have the bottom done, right? Pretty. We have this poofing out. That's good. Let me go ahead and put the stand back on. And I think we need to finish this off. So I am going to cut kind of roughly measure. And since this has pearls and they're sewn on, I'm gonna, before I cut, add glue there. Yeah, right there. And that way that, that little pearl doesn't come undone. And then I'm going to start in the back of the neck here. Okay. Okay. Ooh, ow. Okay. And let's just taper that up there. So I think she's coming along really nicely. Okay, for the top, I think I saw that little, yep. I want that. I think I want that for the top. Now this is, this, I've shown it many times, this beautiful, lace, I just gathered it by sewing each one of these together and just gather it. And now I'm just gonna put this right down in the center there. Yeah. Pretty. Isn't that pretty? Wow. Super pretty. Okay, I want to add one more thing because this doesn't have a hole and this is still popping up. So I'm going to add maybe one of these. And this is just a coffee dyed version of this lace that I used. Just cutting one of those flowers out. Okay, so there we go, and now I can use some glue on the top. Pretty. You can see the dark on the bottom there. Okay. Now we need to fill the bottom in. So I am just going to start. Oh, I love this one to cut the flowers apart. so I won't use that one. Need some softness, so I'm gonna just add fill in those little areas. Okay, and I need more glue. I already have leaves there, so I'm just gonna do a leaf there. I really like it there, though. That's pretty. Yep. See, it all comes together. And we'll just attach this here. Now we need something for this side. We have all these bits here. Need something long on this side. And I don't want to cover this up, so I'm going to tuck it underneath. Oh, there goes my glue. Okay, that's nice. Then what is this one? I like using these. Maybe that could be for a belt. Okay, I like that. Okay. I think she is almost filled in. We need maybe something here. And we've got violet over here, so why don't we... Well, we add some violet right there. Okay, we need something here, and we've got two violets, so maybe a white. Oh, we have this one. Never mind. Okay, so we need something to cover this up here, so. Oh, wow, look at that. I like that. Actually like that. Under, and this is going to go over. Now I can tack that down. And I think I'm going to finish this right here. I think we're done. I don't think I need to add anything else to it. She's pretty full. She's kind of, her dress is high in the front. And when you turn to the back, it's longer, which I like that. I'm just going to add a little bit of glue here so that it stays in place where I want it to. Okay, pretty. Now I just need something here, like a finishing touch. And that's where that flower was going to come in. This one. Okay. Pretty, super pretty. And then on the front, I have something here, so I want something here. Remember, I do where you catch the eye, I like to do the flow where you look here, it draws your eye here with this area, and then I want something here, and then it's going to take you back here, and then you'll be able to see the complete picture. So, do I use another one of these because I used it there? What does that look like? I think I like that. And I really, really do like this. So I think I'm just going to cut one of these. So underneath. Yep. Okay. very pretty. And then I think I have those bows. Yep, there's a bow. How's my time? Okay, my phone is blinking. I'm going to need to stop right here before I get cut off. So don't forget, all of the links are below. Thank you so much, Natasha, for the opportunity all these years to support your store. Natasha is going to start to focus on, or has been focusing on, a new endeavor, which is a health program. And so she will be utilizing all of her time there. The store will still be open. There just won't be a design team driving the sales anymore. So I hope you all liked watching my little tutorial, and I hope that I've inspired you to use your scraps. You know me, I love using scraps, and hope that you will maybe go over to Natasha's scrap a corner and buy some goodies of your own, and maybe play. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you again.